Hello everyone, welcome to all of you. In this lecture we are going to discuss about the living world. So let's start with the introduction. See how wonderful is the living world. You can see extraordinary habitats in this earth like lakes, pond, mountain, deciduous forest, ocean, freshwater lake, desert, hot spring. You can see also the beauty of the galloping horse here and attacking shark. And again you can see here the beauty of this valley, the beauty of this flower. You can see here this various kind of beautiful fishes as well as life. It is emerging inside a desert also. You can see here life, it is emerging inside a river also. You can see these beautiful animals. So in short, life, it is so much beautiful. So as we know, there are so many living organism, like population of that living organism are interacting with each other, as well as in our cell also there are so many reaction it is going on, because there are so many organelles found in our cell, in the structure of our cell. So what indeed is life? So there are this question has two implicit question within it. The first one, it is seeking answer to what living is opposed to the non-living, and the second one, it is philosophical. It is a seeking answer like to what the purpose of life. So as a scientist, we shall not attempt answering the second question, may or may not be. So we'll try to reflect on what is living thing or what is living organism. So for the defining of the living organism, we may have some characteristic on the basis of we can define a living organism, like growth, reproduction and ability to sense with their environments. And some more characteristic we can also add, like metabolism, ability to self-replicate and self-organize. So on the basis of this characteristic, we are able to classify living and non-living things. See, in this chart, in this lecture, we are going to discuss about this portion. So what is living thing? So again, on the basis of these two characteristic or two parameters, we are able to classify living and non-living thing. One is non-defining properties and one is defining properties. So growth and reproduction, both are non-defining properties. Why? We are look in a couple of seconds. See here, this mountain, it is also showing growth. For example, this is small mountain and again it is increasing in there height. So mountain are also showing their growth. And there are some animals who are not able to reproduce themselves. So on the basis of reproduction, we cannot conclude that this is not living thing. And on the basis of growth, we cannot conclude that this is living thing. So let's move on to the first characteristic. I already mentioned it is non-defining properties. See, all the living organism grow. It is usual matter. There is no any rocket science in that. So in plant, you can see there are, you know, cell division, it is take place. In animal also, they are growing either unicellular, multicellular. All the living organism are growing their self. So in vitro culture, by simply counting the number of cell under the microscope, you can say that they are growing. But in majority of higher animals and plant, growth and reproduction are mutually exclusive events. Why? Let's see. As I told you earlier, this mountain, it is also showing growth. See, you can see here, because this is non-living thing, and by accumulating of some material on the surface, this mountain is showing growth. That's the reason we cannot say growth, it is defining property, because non-living thing, it is also showing growth. So mountain, either boulders and sand mold, they all are growing because of accumulation of some material on their surfaces. So because they are non-living thing and they are showing growth, that's the reason we cannot consider growth as an defining properties. So growth, it is non-defining properties. But there is some conditions under which we can say, and the condition, it is inside growth. So in living organism, we can say growth is from inside, because from dividing one cell, By the division of one cell, we are getting two cells. So it is growth from the inside. That's the reason inside growth it showing by link organism. So what question may be asked to you? Does growth is defining property of link organism? So answer will be no. Why? Now you aware about it very well. But there will be a question which is asking you, does inside growth is defining properties of link organism? Then answer will be yes, because question is asking to you about inside growth, and yes, link organism showing inside growth. Now let's move on to the next topic, reproduction. Here also I already mentioned this reproduction, it is non-defining properties. Why? Because see here, in this all thing we will study later on in deep, but you can read here also that all the organism reproduce themselves by asexual mean or sexual mean also. So fungi, planaria, like fungi, it is reproduced by asexual, sexual mean also. In lower organism like yeast, it is also fungi, but it is unicellular. Yeast and hydra, we observe budding. Planaria reproduced by regeneration, fragmentation. So in short, all the link organism are showing reproduction. But why we are not considering reproduction as a defining property? Answer is here. There are some animals like mules, sterile workers bees, infertile human couples, they are not able to reproduce themselves. So on the basis of reproduction, we can say if they are not able to reproduce themselves, so they are not living thing or not living organism. No, that's the reason reproduction also cannot be as an all inclusive defining characteristic. So reproduction, it is non-defining properties of living organism. See mule and hini, you can see here, this is mule and this is hini. They are not able to reproduce themselves. You can say see that the mule, it is hybrid offspring of a male donkey and female horse, and hini, it is opposed to it. So I hope now you are able to understand about the reproduction growth, why we are not considering as a it is defining properties. Now you are able to understand it, because both the characteristic are non-defining properties or non-defining parameters. So hope this video may be helpful to you. If you like this video, so please subscribe my channel.